Well, that was a fun 2 weeks off. I had so many things to move. Have you ever seen the 26-foot-long U-Hauls? Those are those real long ones that, you know, they're just ungodly long and you wonder how anybody could drive those. It took two of those to move everything that we have from northeastern Minnesota to southwestern Minnesota. And if that wasn't good enough, you know, this chair will not stop turning. So I had this 26-foot-long U-Haul and a trailer with an SUV on the back of it, flying down the highway. Here I go again, turning. Flying down the highway with three dogs, two people, and all my plants in the back of the U-Haul. It was fun. It was. I know you might think it might have been crazy and a headache, but you know what? I gotta say that was an excellent adventure. I couldn't find my camera for the longest time, and guess where I found it? I found it in a box where I packed all my shoes. I don't even know why there was a camera in with my shoes, but I found my camera in with my shoes. So, go figure. So if my video smells like feet, I'm so sorry. So I got my plants in the basement right now. As soon as I get done doing this video, I'm going to put them out on the porch and start acclimating them for the garden. And this is my growing area. I set up a area in the basement here just temporarily to keep my plants growing until I can get them outside and try and figure out where I'm going to do a garden or where I'm going to put them up inside the house by windows and stuff, because I have boxes all over the place still, so I really can't have plants floating around all over the place. First thing I want to do is bring you in and show you how everything's doing in here, because this is probably the last time you're going to see a lot of this stuff inside. I'm going to be taking it outside and getting it acclimated to the outdoor weather, because that's what you have to do when you're growing plants inside. Everything is doing fantastic down here because they have all kinds of light, the temperature is controlled, but that's not how it's going to be outside. So when you're growing plants inside, what you'll want to do is, and a lot of people make this mistake, and it's a common mistake, so don't feel bad if you do. A lot of people will just take their plants that are, they keep grabbing each other. Now a lot of people will take plants that are growing inside, doing great underneath grow lights, and then just set them outside, assuming that since they're under bright light here, they can take light outside. That's not true. The plants have to acclimate to a different environment. Plants aren't like people. You can't just walk outside and go, yeah, it's okay. Plants are very strange when it comes to different environments. They'll go through a shock period. So if you take your plants, or if you've ever done this, and throw them directly out into the sunlight, chances are, now this may not have happened, but chances are good, your plants got leaf burned, they wilted, some of them even died, just flat out died. That's because it's a change in temperature as well as light. So you're going to have a nice, cool, controlled environment inside. Then you take your plants outside and it's humid, it could be hot. You don't realize how hot it is, especially if it's on a patio or something. That brick or your house will reflect the heat back to the plant and just roast those poor little babies right to death. So, don't do that. The best thing to do if you set your plants outside is set them in the shade. I know it doesn't seem like they're getting very much light out there, but they're acclimating to the temperature, to the breezes, to the bugs, to all the different things that they're going to be living with outside. Leave them outside in the shade for about, I'd say, a few days. And if the temperature is good enough outside during the night, leave them out there 24 hours a day. That's what I'm going to do with mine. I'm going to put them on a covered porch, leave them out there for, I'd say, about 3 or 4 days, and then start moving them into some morning sun and then afternoon sun, and then they're going to be fine. So, let me bring you in real quick. I'm so disorganized because I got boxes everywhere, I got plants everywhere, but I finally found my camera and I wanted to do a video and show you guys what's going on and how the plants actually survived the move, okay? Come on in. First thing I want to show you is my chocolate army. I really like these things, that's why I'm always showing them off, because I'm really kind of happy with how they're doing. They're still in their cups. This one says pecans. This is not a pecan. But their seed leaves are still attached to the plants. Apparently they use these things forever. But the leaves are getting bigger, they're turning green. When the leaves come out on these, they actually come out like a brownish tan colored, kind of translucent. But then as they get bigger, they turn a darker green and they're more solid looking. You can't see your hand through them. But this is what they look like. They're still quite small, but once they get settled into this environment and I increase their light and put them into a bigger pot, they're going to do fantastic.
But even through the move, even being bashed about, tossed around, knocked down, traveling hundreds and hundreds of miles in the back of a U-Haul, they did fantastic. I'm really proud of them. So, Chocolate Army did fine. I'm just going to do a quick sweep of the pepper plants. I have no idea what these things are. Like I said, I lost the labels, so I really don't know what I'm growing here. This one, that thin one, has flowers on it. So apparently I'm going to find out what it is very soon. And we got a couple more here. So I have 5 pepper plants, and I can't wait to get them outside. I really can't. Remember this monster from next to the fireplace? It really does seem to be taking to this basement environment. It's cool temperatures, bright light, right underneath a light fixture, and it's starting to send out tendrils all over the place. I gotta find a good place for this up on the main floor though. But until then, it's kind of trying to crawl onto my table. Right next to the cousin it plant is the sunflower. Somebody sent me sunflower seeds, and this one is growing right into the light. Whoops, sorry, didn't mean to blind you. But yeah, it's growing right into the light. I couldn't move this tobacco plant the way that it was. It was just way too tall, so I cut it back to about 2 feet tall, and it put out all these side shoots. So now I have multiple, well, here's where I cut it back right here. Now I have multiple plants, and once I get this thing outside, I'm gonna grow this out on a patio because I know tobacco can take full sun. And I mean, come on, it's a southern plant. Of course it could. So this thing is gonna do really, really well here. I'll do updates, I will do updates. I had to show you this. This is doing fantastic. I really am so proud of this pineapple. So it's about the size of a golf ball right now, and I have no idea how big it's going to get. People say that they don't get that big, and it's probably true. I'm sure it's not going to get as big as the one in the store, but the cool thing is that once this turns into a pineapple, it'll have a top as well, and I'm going to cut that top off when I eat the pineapple and plant the top. I'll do lots of updates on this thing because I'm so proud of it. You have no idea how hard it was to move this monstrosity in the back of a U-Haul with my couch and my clothes and lamps and everything. Look at the size of this monster. I'm not going to have a regular sized garden this year because I got so many other things to do. Plus, I want to actually build the raised beds and do videos on that. So this year, I'm going to focus on building raised beds and planning where I'm going to put my garden. And also, I have a garage. I have a 2-car attached garage here, but I also have a detached garage on the other side of the yard that I'm using for a chicken coop and also to store like my lawnmower and stuff like that. So I'll be building a chicken coop for Peabody because I brought Peabody. I didn't bring the turkeys or the chickens. The only bird I brought was Peabody because, you know, it's Peabody. And she's loving it in there because she's not having to deal with the turkeys, which didn't really much like her, and the chickens who would chase her up into the rafters. So now she's got the whole garage all to herself. And apparently down where I live here, it's June bug season. June bugs are those big beetles. I did them on a video before. There are tons of them here. So I catch all these June bugs and I feed her June bugs. And she just loves June bugs, you know. She likes June bugs as much as I like pizza. So she's having a good time in there. I'm going to, later on in the season, order baby chicks and start a new flock. So I'll have baby chicks for her to beat up and chase around. And then by next spring, I'm going to have eggs. There are so many birds here. It's insane. Next video, I'll have everything set up here. So I'm going to show you the house. I'm going to show you the outside, the yard, and where I think I want to put the garden. And I'm going to get your ideas on what I should do, okay? And I'm turning some more. Anyway, I got the trees outside. I have a beautiful lawn, and I'm mowing the grass, and I'm putting it into the chicken coop for Peabody to, you know, kick around in and poop on. So I'm going to make compost out of that. I'm going to do my raised beds this year and build them from scratch and set them up on the lawn and show you how I start raised beds. So that's going to be exciting too. And actually, it's all kinds of good stuff. I am in such a good mood. I've been here about a week or more, and I have been smiling ever since I got here because this is something fantastic for me. I love moving. I love new things. I like gardening, so this is going to give me a chance to start out a whole new garden to show you guys new stuff. I found my camera so I can talk to you guys again. I have an internet connection so I can upload my videos. Okay, I almost hyperventilated there. I was talking so fast.
I'm having a good time. I am having a fantastic time. So I'm back up and running, and thank you so much, everybody, for being so patient. I really do appreciate it. And anyway, I'm going to get this uploaded really quick, and then I got to get some plants out under the porch. I got to go say hi to Peabody, spend some time out in the yard. And turns out there's two swallows that are building a nest right up against my house. So I'm really liking that. When I got here, it was robins raising babies, which I thought was kind of cool because you know me, I like baby robins. And so the robins left the nest, and now swallows have taken over the nest. And so they're kind of fighting off the robins, trying to keep them away. And so I got like bird fights going out in my yard. So I'm feeling right at home. I'm feeling really good. Okay, so anyway, that wraps it up. I just wanted to touch base with everybody and say, hi, I'm still alive, and everything's doing just fine. I'm going to get started on what I do best as soon as I possibly can. And I'll talk to you guys in about a week, all right? So if you have any questions or anything like that about the new place, toss a comment down here, and I will definitely get back to you, all right? All right, well, I got to go. It's great to be back, everybody. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.